sometimes it turns into a sing-along really quick.
Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. Gonna keep on talking, keep on walking, marching into freedom's land. Ain't gonna let no pipeline suck from the ground, suck from the ground, suck from the ground. Ain't gonna let no pipeline suck from the ground. Gonna keep on talking, keep on blocking, walking in freedom's land. The refrain again. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around, turn me around, turn me around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn me around. I'm gonna keep on talking, keep on walking, marching into freedom's land. Ain't gonna let those masters of space lock us down. Lock us down. Ain't gonna let those masters of space lock us down. Gonna keep on talking, keep on walking, marching into freedom's land. Ain't gonna let nobody turn us around, turn us around, turn us around. Ain't gonna let nobody turn us around. Gonna keep on talking, keep on walking, marching into freedom's land. Ain't gonna let nobody turn us around, turn us.
Well, forgive me in advance, I'm probably going to murder some of these names. But the first one is, first speaker is Tulsi Das Shrestha, who is the vice president of the recently formed Global Network chapter in Kathmandu, Nepal, and he's associate professor at Trebovan University. Oh, I'm sorry. Did I hear this wrong?
Could you hold it closer to your mouth, please?
I'm from Nepal, and this country, Nepal, is situated on the lap of highest Mount Everest, and this country is between India and China. China on north and India on south. Today I am being too much happy being together with my big brother, as well as bigger and bigger brothers and sisters. Nepal is the country where Gautama Buddha, the light of the peace, was born. I found two or three Buddhists here. Though Gautama Buddha was born in Nepal, Nepal is a poor country, least developed country. But the Buddhist who has gone from Nepal in other countries and Buddhists of other countries are developing so fast. But we are in 16th century, though this is 21st century. First of all, it's my pleasure and privilege to be here in this very important conference being organized to express our sincere concern against weapons and nuclear power in space. I feel privileged to represent Nepal's chapter of Global Network Against the Weapons and Nuclear Power in Space in my capacity as the Vice President of the Nepal chapter. I was inspired and impressed by the object or the goal which this institution or organization has taken. Because the Global Network Against Weapons, it means we are against Frankenstein monster. The thing which we create will kill us. So we should be against this Frankenstein monster. So I was too much impressed when I met Bruce K. Gagnon in Kathmandu. So I came to know about this network first during my meeting with the coordinator, Bruce, who visited Nepal along with other three members in the month of November 2016. The four members delegation of Global Network had visited Nepal after having attended India Space Conference held in Gitam University, Visakhapatnam, India. Mr. Bruce and other members of delegation visited some of the colleges and think tank centers in Kathmandu. We spoke extensively on the role and objectives of Global Network Against Weapons and Nuclear Power in Space. The focus of their speeches was on highlighting the dangers generated by the installments of the nuclear power in space. Intellectuals in general and professors of Tribhuvan University of Nepal in particular felt very much enlightened by the talk given by Mr. Bruce, Mr. Rao, Dr. Webb, and Mr. Williams. Our students in universities of Nepal were particularly encouraged and inspired by the third providing speeches given by the Global Network delegation. It is only after my first meeting with the delegation of the network that I realized the gravity of the mission of the Global Network. I sincerely congratulate Mr. Coordinator and his team member for taking up this great responsibility of freeing the world of the nuclear power in space in order to safeguard the future of humanity on the Earth. I feel that the objective of Global Network are the universal important, and the message of the network should be spread out all over the world, especially in the nuclear power countries like Americans, Britain, France, China, and Russia. We all know that we are living in a very delicate and vulnerable time of history, because any international or non-international accident of nuclear power in space can eliminate the future of entire humanity. It is with this realization and awareness that Nepal chapter of Global Network has taken up its task seriously and sincerely for arousing the awareness in our younger generation who could voice their protest against nuclear power with greater urgency. Nepal, through a relatively small country, Nepal, though relatively a small country without nuclear power, is not also free from the danger of nuclear power in art and in space, as we are situated between two giants, means on the North China and the South India. Two giant nuclear power countries like China and India. Our another neighboring country, Pakistan, is also equipped with nuclear power. So, in such situation, we cannot remain indifferent to the risk created by nuclear power. An accidental war between these two countries, meaning Pakistan and India, India and China, any two countries, could wipe out the map of the Nepal. So, my concern represents the fear and worry of Nepal, like non-nuclear power. Countries who cannot remain silent when the future of entire globally is at stake. I hope that nuclear power countries will listen to our genuine role and concern in order to prevent the world from reaching an invisible stage of the nuclear power rivalry. In today's world, it is either we live together or we get swamped and drawn together. There is no way of saving ourselves when our people become the victim of nuclear power war. I am sorry to mention here that President and Secretary General could not be present along with me from the Nepal because they were not issued visa by the Embassy of United States of America, USA. Because we Nepali people are poor. And I think also the Indian people are not given visa easily. And in the case of the Nepal, or in the case of Nepali people, the consular team thinks that Nepali people are going to America for earning money or for living there. They will come back if they are issued visa. So they were not given. I carry the message of our President and Secretary General for the grand success of the country. I would have a happier person if two senior friends of Nepal Network had also been issued visa and would be able to come here together. However, I assure the conference that I will go back to Nepal with a strong message given by the conference, and then we'll carry out our global network related programs with more enthusiasm. I once again thank the coordinator for kindly giving me this opportunity to visit America and participate in this international conference that carries immense significance at a time when people around the world are worried about their future. I take this opportunity also to call upon the leaders of America, Britain, and other nuclear power countries to realize the gravity of the problem and the immediate step to denuclearize the space so that humanity on the earth could live with peace and tranquility. So we Nepali people are poor, but I have come here to show the solidarity with you, hoping the conference would take the way for making us free from the fear of weapons, from the fear of war and other. Nepal is a small country, and Nepali people are suffering from those days. From 1995 to 2005, Nepali people were suffering because of the problem of Maoists. Near about 18,000 people were killed in that period. After 10 years, when this problem was solved, the king was thrown out from the throne. And it was said people are made free from the ruler who were ruling cruelly from those days to that time. but the people were not grateful because of the greediness of the politicians, selfishness of the politicians, because of the selfishness and other feelings which they were taking. It is the Kalti Age provided all the facilities to progress, but due to the lack of the true leaders or politicians, it is not being able to progress. The country is not being able to progress. Before 2 years, there was an earthquake. Near about 8,000 to 9,000 people died. And when there was an earthquake, after the earthquake, there was blockage of the India. In a hand, people were suffering by the effect of the earthquake. In the other hand, they were suffering due to the blockage of the India. I think Nepal will get the opportunity to progress in the future, because we are also with you, and we will also spread the message which this our nation has taken. And I have given permission to read 3 or 4 lines about the peace. So, universal peace. Peace is the breath of our spirit. Peace is the breath of our spirit. It wells up from within the depths of our being. To repress, to heal, to inspire. Peace is our birthright. Peace is our birthright. Its eternal presence exists within us as a memory of where we have come from and as a vision of where we aim to go. Our world is in the midst of the change. For millions we have contemplated, reasoned, and practiced the idea of the peace. Yet the capacity to sustain peace eludes us. To transcend the limits of our own thinking, we must acknowledge that peace is our then cessation of the conflict. For peace to move across the face of the earth, we must realize, as the great philosophers and leaders before us, that all people desire peace. We hereby acknowledge this truth that is universal. Now, humanity must desire those things that make for peace. We have sufficient time, so I would like to in this form here. Anyway, I would like to thank all the peace lovers here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. Our next speaker is Jay Narayana Rao, who comes from the railroad trade union background and is a peace activist from India. He is one of the board of directors of the Global Network, and he organized a national space issue conference last fall in his country, India.